Greetings world. We are anonymous. We do not forgive, we do not forget. Expect us. Jack Parcells, a 12-year-old youth, remains in the Alberta Children's Hospital recovering from a fractured skull, partial hearing loss and other external injuries in the hands of the Calgary police, according to his parents. His mother and father said they were worried their son, who has autism, would hurt himself the evening of Wednesday, August 22, and called 911 to get help. Jack's mom said she told the dispatcher as well as the two responding Calgary police officers about her son, that he's autistic, he has anxiety, ADHD, and he was at her parents' house, and that he hasn't taken his medications for the last 4 days and he's ramped up and she couldn't get him to calm down. She wanted the officers to take her son to the hospital where he could get some mental health crisis intervention, but instead, Jack's parents said he suffered physical injuries by the very person they expected would help. Jack's father said he is still in disbelief. The father said for 12 years they kept him safe and that they always said, if ever you're in trouble, just find someone in a uniform, and his first interaction with police, he slammed to the ground and busts his head open? How do we tell him that's okay? Once the two officers arrived, the Parcells said police attempted to get their son into the police cruiser, and that's when the episode escalated. Jack was upset and swore at the officer who was about to handcuff him. He had his hands behind his back and he said, you bastard, you're not going to cuff me, and then the mother said that is when she heard a pop and looked up, he's on the ground and blacked out, so she bent down to pick him up, held him in her arms and said, Jack, Jack, wake up. Talk to mom, the father said he saw the incident unfold. In anger and in response to being called a name, the police officer took him by the upper body and he slammed him into the concrete in 2 seconds full force. There was no fall, he was body slammed by this officer they called to help him. The father said, I yelled, what did you do? What did you do? Then the police officer looked at him and said, he fell. The police of course doesn't want to admit it by stating that the boy was taken into custody for transport to the hospital and was not cooperative. During the course of the struggle with our officers, the boy was injured, but they are not taking responsibility on how he was injured. Aside from the fact Jack is autistic, even if he wasn't, you don't treat a 12-year-old that way, you don't treat an adult that way. Nobody deserves this. CPS also said its members take any in-custody injury seriously, especially those involving a minor, and added the incident did not have the outcome that anyone involved wanted, which is obvious, and also stated that their officers are trained to resolve situations with as little risk as possible to themselves, the public and the people we take into our custody. Which is not the truth, because as of today, August 26, the Calgary's police chief says that more education and training is needed to help avoid situations like this incident. And the situation is an example of how officers need to have more training and equipment to deal with those with mental illnesses. While the officers who attended the scene were escorting him outside, the boy began to struggle and somehow suffered a head injury. The police are not saying how it was causes, but doctors soon found that the youth had fractured his skull and suffered abdominal injuries during his interaction with police. The Alberta Serious Incident Response Team has been called to investigate this case. Police determined the boy may have been off his medication for days and had been locked in a bedroom. Investigators say when the officers tried to take him to hospital he struggled and injured his head. Paramedics were then called and he was taken to hospital, where the boy's parents were advised that he had suffered a fracture to his skull. At the time the youth was struggling with officers, was not handcuffed and had not yet been placed in the police vehicle. Perhaps the parents could be false accusing? A report on use of force released 3 months ago by former Chief Justice detailed the need for specialized and focused crisis intervention training. Authorities also need more frequent training when interacting with people with mental health conditions. A Mount Royal University Justice Studies professor said it's likely those training recommendations haven't yet been implemented. The question I have is, did officers have sufficient training dealing with a youth in crisis to be able to deal with this in a manner that would not have led to this? The family and the public should be comforted by the fact ASSERT is on the case. One Calgary professional who conducts specialized training for first responders said she offered her program to the Calgary Police Service. The training had been adopted by the Calgary Fire Department in 2016, but according to the Special Needs Advocacy and Education Network, her offer was turned down by the Calgary Police Service. In a statement by the CPS, they say our police force feels confident with their officers in their dealings with the public, and at the time we discussed training, they didn't see the need to do mandatory training with autism and special needs. The Calgary Police Service said their officers are trained to not try to diagnose any mental health illnesses when responding to calls, and this is outside of their expertise and can lead to inappropriate responses if the officers are mistaken. Instead, Officers are trained to determine their response based on the behavior of the individual to which they are responding, with a focus on de-escalating the situation whenever possible. Scenarios and training on how to manage mental health crises are also worked into the training new officers receive on controlling and communicating with subjects. This all comes after a 49-year-old man died following an altercation with two Canada Border Services Agency officers on a flight to Amsterdam from Calgary on August 7, where both the agency and police said the man was in medical distress and was taken to hospital, where he was pronounced dead around 4:30 p.m. We are anonymous. We do not forgive, we do not forget. Expect us.